फिजिक्स क्लास 12 चैप्टर 5 मैग्नेटिज्म एंड मैटर। वी आर डूइंग मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मटेरियल्स। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड डायमैग्नेटिज्म एंड पैरामैग्नेटिज्म। डायमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स आर द सब्सटेंस व्हेन यू प्लेस देम इन एन एक्सटर्नल फील्ड दे विल गेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट बट इन द अपोजिट सेंस दैट ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। But in paramagnetism, they get weakly magnetized when you are placing them in the external magnetic field. Now we'll continue with ferromagnetism. Ferromagnetic substance gets weakly, strongly magnetized when placed in external magnetic field. So they are, para will get weakly magnetized, ferro will get strongly magnetized. Here we have to define one more term called domain. The dipole moment of individual atom combined to form a volume having its own permanent dipole moment. That volume inside material is called domain. So here we'll not consider one individual atom but the group of atoms which form a volume. In that one volume, one unit of volume, you'll get approximately 10 to the power 11 atoms. So all these together form a volume. Okay, see in this figure I have shown. This arrow, this which I am showing, is the dipole domains and their magnetic moment is shown. When an external magnetic field B naught is applied, domain orient themselves in direction of B and form giant domain. So here you can see, here they are randomly in motion. Okay, their direction is random. But when you are applying in external magnetic field, they will have the direction towards the in the direction of the magnetic field. So this is one individual domain, but now together, combined together, they become a giant domain. So this becomes a whole substance, ferromagnetic substance, as the domain, giant domain, and all the magnetic moments are in the one direction, the direction of the applied magnetic field. Therefore ferromagnetic field lines are highly concentrated. So if you draw the magnetic field lines, they will be highly, just like a strong magnet. Hard magnetic materials. When external field is removed, if the magnetization persists, then they are called hard magnetic materials. So now this is my ferromagnetic material. Apply the external magnetic field, the domains are get oriented. Now suppose you remove the magnetic field, external magnetic field, but still these domains remain oriented or the magnetization remains, then you call them as a hard magnetic materials. Examples are alnico, that is alloy of iron, aluminium, nickel, cobalt, copper. Then there is a naturally found hard material, that is lodestone, is naturally occurring such material. Next is soft ferromagnetic material. We saw hard ferromagnetic materials, now soft ferromagnetic materials. The magnetization disappears in removal of external field are called soft ferromagnetic materials. So now as I say, now suppose you remove this external magnetic field, then again they come back to the original position, then you consider them as soft ferromagnetic materials. And the example for this is soft iron. At high temperature, ferromagnet becomes paramagnet. In that domain, disintegrates with temperature. We know that ferromagnet materials all are depending on the temperature. So in a change of temperature, ferromagnetic material will become paramagnetic. That means in the ferromagnet, you see these domains are oriented, but with the change in temperature, this orientation will get disoriented. Okay, that means domain disintegrate with temperature, and the temperature of transition from ferro to para is called Curie temperature. So the temperature at when the ferromagnetic material becomes paramagnet, we call it as a Curie temperature, and that symbol is used, Tc. And the relation is Ki is equal to C divided by T minus Tc. Tc is a Curie temperature, C is the Curie constant, and Ki, we know it is a susceptibility. For ferromagnetic substance, Ki is very, very greater than 1, permeability, relative permeability also very greater than 1, and mu is very, very greater than mu naught. Okay, so we have seen the Curie temperature. Now in the textbook we have given for some substance the Curie temperature. We'll just go through it. It is, the temperature is given in the Kelvin, degree Kelvin. कोबाल्ट 1394, आयरन 1043, Fe2O3 893, निकल 631 डिग्री केल्विन एंड गैडोलिनियम 317 डिग्री केल्विन. ओके, सो दिस इज क्यूरी टेम्परेचर फॉर सब सब्सटेंस गिवन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. सो वी हैव डन फेरोमैग्नेटिज्म एंड नेक्स्ट वी शैल डू हिस्टेरिसिस कर्व. सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मटीरियल्स. फर्स्ट वी हैव सीन डायमैग्नेटिक, देन पैरामैग्नेटिज्म एंड फेरोमैग्नेटिज्म. डायमैग्नेटिज्म गेट मैग्नेटाइज इन ऑपोजिट सेंस, पैरा इन सेम सेंस, एंड फेरो इज स्ट्रांगली मैग्नेटाइज. थैंक यू वेरी मच.